Here's this week's My Boat feature.
As long as man's been powering boats, there's been one pursuit. That's the chase for more speed. And of course, more speed takes horsepower, and it also takes great boats. So this week, we're gonna start a two-part My Boat on marrying the two, the old with the new. And what we're working with here is this new production, but it's a classic design. It's a 1920s 21-foot gentleman racer by Clarion that Rich and Linda Hughes have been finishing here in their shop. But what we're going to put into this is some serious horsepower with the latest technology from Mercury, and that's their 6.2 liter 350 horsepower. And to that, we're going to add all of the sophisticated controls and systems. So beyond all of the normal controls that's required for the engine, we've selected from Mercury Racing their zero effort digital throttle and shift that's going into the boat. And to manage all of the systems, we're going with their Vessel View 7 that brings up all of the information from the engine and other systems in the boat onto one easy to use and easy to read screen. So this is where we're going to start, is putting these basic components into the boat. What was driving, what was the idea behind what's going on here with powering this boat?
So the Mercury 6.2 is the latest that Mercury's come out with, being their own cast block, not a Chevrolet block, but a Mercury block. We wanted to push technology and go as far as we could with this boat.
From the interior design, you've got a goal there as well.
I've always been partial to the British sports cars, so when you see the upholstery in the boat, you'll see a lot of cues being taken from the old Jaguars and Aston Martins. So now the real trick was to blend that with the new technology. So that's why we tried to blend the Vessel View and the shifter controls in with the older style look.
Rich and Linda had completed the interior components, so our task was just to install the electronics and controls, starting with hiding the GPS antenna in the console. Next, the ignition key was installed, followed by the digital throttle and shift control. While accessible, the DTS harness was rigged with connections to DTS control lever 1 and foot control to the shifter, and the ignition was connected to the harness as well. We then moved on to plugging in the Vessel View adapter harness into the display on the bench. That done, the display was passed on to Rich to secure in the dash. After getting the complete console into the boat, the project moved to the back of the helm and the engine compartment.
Somebody here has been really busy, Rich. You've done a lot of the pre-wiring for the boat and some of the Mercury components here as well. You've got all of your auxiliary wiring separate from the engine, the non-Mercury components started here. But I've noticed you've adapted the Mercury switchable power to some of your own wiring.
The harness that originally comes from Mercury to do that is quite long, and it wasn't required. So a harness using part of the componentry was made up, but we have to put in the control unit that runs the throttle and shift and everything. And of course, the junction box, so all of the various elements of the harnesses come together and eventually connect into the engine. Thanks to Rich's pre-planning, it only took a few minutes to secure the control unit and the 6-port junction box. Next, the main engine harness was plugged into the control unit.
We've got all of the electronics done for the Vessel View system and everything required for the controls. So on part two next week, we'll be moving on to installing the brand new Mercruiser 6.2 liter.